medianoche on Channel 37 here in Nueva York, and I am so excited because today I can speak Spanish on the air again. Let's see, Abajo la misma luna or la misma luna and la director, and I'm going to slip back into English and say Patricia Riggen. That sounds Irish to me, Patricia.
It's Irish.
It is Irish. Yes. So you're part Irish, part Mexican?
I am full Mexican. With an Irish background, an American great-grandfather who fought the Civil War or something like that.
Oh, and you're so beautiful. You could be a supermodel, and you're a director.
But I'm like this short, you know.
Oh, I can't tell. I know, our countries are right next to each other, and they couldn't be more different. And that's why it's so nice that Under the Same Moon is the title in English. Mm-hmm. And it's such a great concept. Do you want to tell our viewers what the film's about? It's a beautiful, beautiful film.
Yes, the movie's about a boy and a mom who are separated by the border between the U.S. and Mexico. So it starts with that, and then it's about the journey that this boy embarks in to go look for his mom.
It's such a good idea. It's such a good. Was this also a Mexican female writer wrote
this? Yes, she's Mexican. Came to the States when she was 11 years old. Her name is Ligia Villalobos, and it's a beautiful idea that she brought to me, and just allows for so much.
Yes. Well, it's just. I always bring up the word Dickensian, you know, like Charles Dickens, like you can't go wrong with an orphan, you know, or a little kid going through like this kind of Oliver Twist like situation with the Border Patrol and trying to get, it's just because he's been separated from his mother and he doesn't understand why, and it's because of money and that she's come to America. To earn more money to send back to him, but he wants her. He doesn't care about the money. He wants his mother.
And at the same time, you know, she's having her own dilemma right there, thinking, did I do well? Did I do the right thing or not? Because, you know, many of these women, and we see many of them lately, are forced by poverty to make these decisions, to leave their children behind. And then, you know, in this case, Rosario's, you know, realizing if it was worth it or not.
And so, the green card rules vary so much from person to person. And they're so, I mean, people who have maids like I do, you know, I mean, you're constantly involved with this topic of like the family is back in South America and they're here and they're trying to, you know, and I keep thinking, is this a better life living in the Bronx? I'm not sure.
I know, that's part of her dilemma too, right? I think she even says it, you know, living in a garage, hiding from everyone, you know, being persecuted as a criminal.
Right, and she was also a house cleaner, which I did that too, yes I did, back in England, to live in England, so those women were very accurate. Awful women that she worked for. Oh, one of them was a transvestite. I wasn't sure. And she's so nasty to her. And she has to go door to door to find work because she can't go through an agency because she's illegal.
Actually, I had two people she worked for, and one was a nice woman.
Yeah.
You know, it's good to keep the balance because that's how reality is. I think there are good people and bad people on both sides of the border, and in the case of the bad landlady, she was there to sort of, you know, symbolize the impotence of immigrants that they face sometimes because they, since they're here illegally, they don't have any rights. So they can be abused in many ways, and they can't defend themselves.
And Patricia, you're wonderful, you're brilliant, tú eres brillante, and I could talk to you, hablo mucho por muchos tiempo, pero nada tiempo is left, so we have to say goodbye. I hope I see you again, my God, you're so brilliant, and I love your movie.
The movie's opening in March 19, and I hope everybody can see it.
March 19th, bueno, gracias, señora, para todos.
Thank you.